गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक टू माई वीडियो. दिस इज़ द वीडियो ऑफ क्लास 9 सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैड सीन दैट दैट मीन्स द टिश्यू. वी हैड स्टार्टेड द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज टिश्यू एंड वी हैड कम्प्लीटेड द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट एज वेल एज वी हैड कम्पेयर्ड बिटवीन द प्लांट टिश्यू एंड द एनिमल टिश्यू. So today we will start with our plant tissue. That means a small section of plant tissue we are going to conduct over here. So what is plant tissue? The tissue that is present in the plant are known as plant tissue. So mainly plant tissue, it is categorized into two type. That means now how they are categorizing? Actually they are categorizing according to their ability to divide. So it is written here meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. They are divided according to the ability to divide. If they are having the ability to divide throughout the life, this is called the meristematic tissue. The permanent tissue, will stop in certain aging. That means the permanent tissue is having an aging period. After that period, they will stop divide. But meristematic tissue is known as the growing tissue. That means throughout the life, they will grow. So here we can see this is the figure of meristematic tissue. And this is the diagram of a permanent tissue. So further, meristematic tissue can be divided into three categories. Here, that means meristematic means growing tissue. The growing tissue, what is the growing tissue? That means it will grow throughout the life. So it is basically divided into three part. First one is the apical meristem. Second is the intercalary and third is the lateral meristematic. So basically meristematic tissue is divided into three part: apical, intercalary and lateral. And in the the permanent one we will see just later. So let's start with the meristematic tissue. So basically we had seen over here the position of the three things. First thing is the apical, intercalary and lateral. So these are the three important thing of the meristematic tissue. Now just see the location where they live, where this tissue lives in the plant. First, we start with the apical. Here, three are there: apical, intercalary, and meristematic. So, if this is the plant, the up one, the top one, where I am indicating over here, the top one, the new growth. So, this one is known as the apical. That means the apical tissue is just present in the newly cell. That means the new part of the plant. In the top part where you might have seen the growth, the small growth and the full greenery part, the over there the apical tissues are present. Second thing, we are having the intercalary. Now you can see the stem part. Okay, in the stem part you can see a node over here. That means what we call gatha. That node, over in that node the intercalary is present. That means the division of that one, the internodes in the branches, in the stems, the intercalary tissue is present. That means we can say in the apical part, the apical part is responsible. Intercalary, that means the growth of the branches, the stems, is due to the intercalary. Now the last one, that is the lateral. So here we can see the lateral part. That means the thickness ऑफ द दिस वन द स्टेम्स इज ड्यू टू द लैटरल वन. सो हियर ऑल्सो वी कैन सी दैट दिस वन द सो दिस इज अ लैटरल मेरिस्टमैटिक. दैट मीन्स थ्री थिंग्स आर प्लेस प्रेजेंट. फर्स्ट वन अपिकल इन द टॉप पार्ट, सेकेंड इन द नोड्स एंड थर्ड इन द स्टेम्स. दैट मीन्स इट विल जस्ट डिवाइड द स्टेम पार्ट. दैट मीन्स थिकनेस ऑफ द स्टेम इज डिवाइड ड्यू टू द लैटरल मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू. सो इफ वी सी द बेसिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू वी विल गेट दैट अनस्पेशलाइज्ड सेल दैट कैन डिवाइड इट डेफिनेटली टू प्रोड्यूस द न्यू सेल. वॉट आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट द मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू दैट इट इज़ द ग्रोइंग टिश्यू. दैट मीन्स इट विल ग्रो थ्रू आउट देयर लाइफ. इट इज़ अनस्पेशलाइज्ड. अनस्पेशलाइज्ड मीन्स दैट मीन्स इट इज़ नॉट स्पेशलाइज्ड टू डू अ स्पेसिफिक फंक्शन. जस्ट लाइक आवर हैंड इज देयर. आवर हैंड इज स्पेशलाइज टू डू एनी वर्क, टू फाइट, टू ईट, टू होल्ड एनीथिंग. आवर लेग इज स्पेशलाइज टू रन. आवर हार्ट इज स्पेशलाइज टू पम्प. आवर ब्लड इज स्पेशलाइज टू मूव. सो देर इज अ स्पेशलाइजेशन, वॉट वी कॉल्ड स्पेशलिस्ट. सो द मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स आर नॉट कन्वर्टेड टू द स्पेशलाइज सेल. सो वी कैन से दैट इट इज अनस्पेशलाइज एंड इट इज नॉट हैविंग अ प्रोपर फंक्शन. इफ अनस्पेशलाइज सेल कन्वर्टेड इन टू स्पेशलाइज सेल दैट मीन्स वी कैन से दैट इज द परमानेंट सेल. नाउ मेरिस्टमैटिक इज द रीजन वेयर मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स डिवाइड. मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू इज यूजली फाउंड एट द एपेक्स और रूट एंड शूट पार्ट. सो वट इज द एपेक्स ऑफ रूट एंड शूट पार्ट? दिस पार्ट. दैट मीन्स द रूट दैट इज कमिंग डाउन साइड. दैट मीन्स ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटी. सो ओवर हियर द यू कैन सी द न्यू growth of the root, the white white part you might have seen. So that white part is also, that means over there also there is a meristematic tissue is present, and that is the apex part. Apex tissue is present, apical meristematic is present over there, and they are just dividing. So let's see the function of the meristematic tissue. So some characteristics are over here. So let's see. The meristematic tissue have small cells with thin cell wall. That means they are having the cell wall. So it is plant tissue. Plant tissue will have the cell wall. So they are having the cell wall, but it is very, very thin. So cells have large nuclei. So why there is a large nuclei present in the... So they are the... That means unspecialized as well as the... growing tissue. So there is a large nuclei present. Cell have very small vacuole and they lack intracellular space. That means in the meristematic tissue there is no intracellular space. That means they can't change their shapes. Okay, now the next point is remain young forever and divide actively throughout the life of the plant. What I was telling repeatedly you all, that it divide throughout their life and they just remain young. That means every time the new cells are just comes, that means it divide. In plants, this tissue are found in the tip of the root, shoots and internodes and buds in between the xylem and the phloem, under the epidermis of dicotyledon plants and also producing branches of the root. So whatever I've shown you in the diagram, that means they are present in the roots. Roots means the down part. Okay, just like this you can see the whitish color, that is just newly growth. They are over there. The cells are present in the stems, you have seen the nodes, you have seen the buds. That means the newly growth of the seed over there you will see. In between the xylem and the phloem also you can see the meristematic tissue, under the epidermis of dicotyledon. In the dicotyledon also we can see and the also producing branch roots, the branches of the roots are also over there. There is a help of the meristematic tissue. So these are the things up to the that means of the meristematic tissue. Just once again, I'm just telling some points of the apical part. That means the meristematic part. See, in the apical part, they are found in the root and the shoot part. That means they are found in the shoot part and in the root part. So this is the apical one, and they help in the increasing in the length of the plant. That means it will, when it will grow the upside, it will, the growth will be large. So it helps in the increasing the length of the plant. Now here, intercalary. Where is intercalary? Intercalary is over here. So they are found in the base of the internode. So here is a node. In the node, they are basically present. So you might have seen the bamboo grasses. Okay. So basically, they are present in the grasses and the bamboos. So help in the increasing of the internodes. That means what we called gathana, it will just increase its length. The last one is the intercalary. They are found on the side of the roots, stems and its branches. That means intercalary, you have seen the thickness of the stems. So to increase this thickness, the intercalary is present, and they just that means they help in this the division of this section. That means the what we can see the thickness part. The responsibility of thickness part is just in the lateral meristematic. So we have finished our today's video. In the next video, we are going to see the other part, that is the permanent tissue.